Hey guys, welcome to another episode of On The Media. I'm your host, Shaheem Haynes, and today I'm here with Bailey, Simon, and Nikesh. And today we'll be talking about our unique perspectives that we gathered from our interviewees on media and technology. So starting off with who we interviewed, first, I interviewed my mother, Latasha Wiggins. She is 49 years old. Bailey?
I interviewed my grandmother, Elaine Ballou, and she's 82 years old.
I also interviewed my grandmother. She's 86 as well.
I interviewed my mother. She's 55, and her name is Sunita.
So the first question we asked was, how was their media use as a kid? So starting off with my mother, she really talked about only having a TV, not really using the newspaper or the radio, just mainly using the TV at home to kind of connect. What about you, Bailey?
My grandmother, she used the news a lot through the radio and newspapers. And her favorite part about the newspaper was the comics.
My grandmother also used the newspaper a lot. She used to read the jokes that were in the fun section. And she also listened to radio with her family at dinner.
My mother said something similar. The main source of communication was just letters that sent out. And the main source of media was just newspaper and radio.
That's good stuff right there. So the next question we asked was, how is the media use right now? Starting with you, Bailey.
My grandmother is actively on Facebook because there's a lot of great-grandchildren and grandchildren that she has to keep up with that don't live near us. And specifically, she likes to learn new things. Like, she joined a canning group and she learned how to can milk on Facebook, so.
My grandmother uses a lot of Instagram. She has all her grandkids in there, and every time I post anything, he'll reply and we'll get together from there.
My mother was is all addicted to YouTube and Facebook. So I love that she's addicted to YouTube because I get to try a lot of new recipes every time I go home, and I love it. It's delicious. Although I feel like Facebook has a lot of fake media that she consumes, which might affect her in a negative way. Although this might be my third person effect kicking in, because I feel like it wouldn't affect me as much because I am more media literate, let's say, whereas my mother would be more prone to believing fake news or fake information that she consumes.
That's good stuff. So moving forward, the next question we asked our interviewees was, did they think that our generation was missing out by having access to this advanced technology? Start with you, Bailey.
Well, my grandmother said that we weren't really missing out on hanging out with friends because we can still do that like they did. It's a little different, but it's remotely the same. But she then brought up the fact that, because like from her perspective, when she was learning things from Facebook, like canning and stuff, she thinks that we have so much access to learn things that we never would have thought to learn before.
My grandmother thinks similar. She told me an example that her parents came from Italy and they lost every contact with like her family and relatives. So now she's like a continent apart from me, and we can still talk, and I don't miss anything about her.
My mother kind of had a little mixed opinion on this one, because just like how you guys said, it is amazing because we have so much information at the tip of our fingertips. But on the other hand, she also pointed out the negative side, which is like the children basically are so addicted to media devices that they get caged inside their own houses, which leads to them having a negative impact on their mental as well as physical health.
Thank you. So the next question we asked was, how was it for them getting their first cell phone or computer? Did any of you guys have anything interesting?
Actually, my mother did her bachelor's and master's, and she pointed out that while she was doing her bachelor's thesis, she had to handwrite the whole thesis, which was like 20 or 30 pages long, and if you make any mistake, you gotta start over. So she was talking about how like that was so stressful, it strained her hand a lot and things like that. But then when she got to her master's, she got her first computer and she was able to use it and use Word, which made it so much easier and faster to write her master's thesis.
Bailey, what about you?
My grandmother, she said that her first cell phone looked like, well, she called it a candy bar because it looked and shaped like a candy bar. So,
my grandmother also called, she had a Nokia for his first phone, and she called it a brick because how stiff it was. And she couldn't believe like portable phones were real at the time. So,
All right, and then the last question we finished off with them is, how do they think, how do they feel about technology moving forward? Any of you guys get anything interested from that?
Yeah, I do. My grandmother, she had knee reconstruction about a year ago, and the doctor came in and he was like, okay, bad news, the robot that we normally use for the knee reconstructions like out of commission, but I can still do it because he's a doctor, he went to school for it. And my grandma was like, no, like I want the robot to do it because it's so precise and like the detail that goes into the machines now, especially in the future, what they will be able to do will be incredible.
Yeah, it was interesting on my side as well because she was talking about how like she couldn't even imagine how things would have been right now. Like she couldn't even imagine like we could talk on our cell phone halfway across the world to me, even video calling. So she was more like, it's unimaginable because you can't even fathom what technology can do in the future.
That's some good stuff right there. So thank you guys today. Thanks for being with us today and sharing those unique perspectives. That's all we got for you today, and we'll see you guys.